you know, the retreat was such a blessing. And, you know, we were asked to just think about how did God invest in us and what does it really mean for him to invest in us? And I went back to 2 Corinthians with a group that I studied the Bible with here. And we were reading in 2 Corinthians 7 about how Paul was going through a period of real struggle. And God served him by sending Titus to come and sit with him in the midst of his struggle. And that was the way that God had comforted and guided Paul in that moment. And Titus, in turn, had been blessed by his visits with the Corinthians. And as I thought more about the retreat, I reflected that that's what I experienced at the retreat, that, you know, God came into my life through all the various Christians that were at the retreat. I found it to be an incredibly warm time of fellowship. Every heart was open, despite what Gavin said about being angry on the first day. The overall impression that people's hearts were open, willing to speak with each other, and like Ofoname also reflected, to cross over the barriers of the different careers and backgrounds that we had, the variations and wealth and experience kind of faded away because of the depth of our shared identity in Christ. So at the retreat, I just felt that I was being invested in kind of minute over minute, not only by the program that was put together with such care, but also by the individuals that I interacted with over coffee and over meals and over glasses of wine. That was a great experience for me. I think that it really, that investment into me, this pouring of personal presence into me at the retreat, really allowed me to think about my own path and consider some of the things I've been studying, and to feel more able to share out of that experience. And I appreciated that. So when I was called on to speak on Saturday, it was very easy to get up and just to share just what I was feeling, the things that were in my heart and in my head as I was studying investment as a theme. And so kind of following some other Christians on what to do with our investments, I just walked the group through an example of, on the one hand, laying out our investment retirement funds, where we're buying stocks and bonds and where we have our cash stored, and then comparing that to our charitable giving and asking, why would there be such a difference in logic between the two, that one is entirely aimed at making money and the other is entirely focused on the good that's being done by the various charities that we invest in. And I asked, if before the face of Christ, if the difference in this logic on how we invest our funds is really justifiable. And I suggested at the end of that we ought to consider all of our investments as a moral opportunity first, and then second, to think about return and risk. After the retreat, Peter mentioned that he had written a booklet that that said the very same thing or something very close to it about 20 years ago. So I was happy to be repeating ideas from a much more thoughtful person. I think after the retreat, I've been thinking more about the kind of opportunity to work in my own life and to serve others and thinking about investment. So it's freed me up to consider maybe even leaving my job to go into full-time studies to help people further think about some of these issues. And Don at the retreat had mentioned that after retreats, it's tough to return home and keep that same momentum of the experience. And I find that that's the case, but it still planted these seeds in me to think about my own walk and my own career differently. And I really appreciate the freedom that it involved.